you doing in here, Birdsworth?
Just on my way to the laundry, Miss Bennet.
Well, get moving.
I'm going.
See you, Trace.
And you can wipe that look off your face, Morris.
Do you have to be so harsh to everyone?
Harsh? Do you expect to be treated with kid gloves in here?
No, of course not.
I'm only carrying out my duties the way they ought to be carried out. You're going to have to get used to prison officers and their little idiosyncrasies, Morris.
I hope I won't be in here that long.
Oh, I'm not talking about in here. I'm talking about your home life.
What?
Your father's seeing an awful lot of Mrs. Jackson lately. Bit of a shock, I suppose. When you're inside to find your father's having an affair with one of the prison officers.
In love, we could do with an extra worker.
Judy, I need to talk to you.
It's private.
Honey, what's wrong with you? You look sick.
It's Dad. He's having an affair with Mrs. Jackson.
What? Now, who told you that garbage?
Miss Bennet.
Yeah, well, that figures. You don't believe her, do you?
I don't know. All my life, I've waited for him to have time for me. I really thought we were getting close. And then he gets involved with some woman and I've forgotten. She's not just any woman, she's a screw.
Now, honey, don't you think you're jumping the gun a bit? You want to find out the truth, you ring up your father. Then who will you believe, him or her?
He'd never lie to me.
Just take it easy. Now, honey, don't you think you're jumping the gun a bit? You want to find out the truth, you ring up your father. Then who will you believe, him or her?
He'd never lie to me.
Just take it easy. Liz, you don't think Vera's going to have a sex change operation, do you?
What? Huh? Yeah. No, don't be so stupid.
What is this, tea break or something, is it? Morris, you're either working in here or you're not. Which is it?
I'm just going, Mr. Fletcher.
Good. And perhaps the rest of you can get on with some work, eh? Let's see some action around here.
Have you got the new rosters yet?
No, I'm working on it.
Well, I hope they're an improvement over the last lot. There is a limit to what we can do, you know.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means I've been working double shifts for weeks and I'm a physical wreck.
I'd say it'd be more than work that's wrecking your health, Miss Bennet. So let's not go blaming the rosters, shall we?
Now, good morning, Mr. Fletcher. Am I too early to see Tracy?
No, you're not, Mr. Morris. If you just sign in there, I'll go and get her for you.
I'd appreciate it if you keep it brief, Mr. Morris. We're very short-staffed and I've got a lot of work to do.
Oh, yeah, thanks. I'll try. Well, how are you, darling? Tracy, is there something wrong?
Why don't you tell me? I'm stuck in here going stark raving mad while you're outside living it up.
Living it up? What are you talking about?
I'm talking about a certain grey lady with whom you seem to be more than just good friends.
Oh. Yes. As a matter of fact, I have been seeing her. She happens to be a very special person. But I can't understand why you don't approve after all she's done for us.
What's she done apart from take you away from me when I need you the most?
Don't talk like a child. No one's taken me away from you. I'm here now, aren't I?
Oh, for how long? And when are you seeing her again?
As it happens, we're having lunch later. Tracy, what's wrong?
I'm sick of sharing you. I've done it all my life. So make up your mind. It's either her or me.
Lizzie, will you extract your digit? Person get bored to death waiting for you.
Oh, all right, I'll help you.
Oh, Lizzie, you're here. I wasn't sure you'd be back from lunch.
Oh, I wish I hadn't bothered. I've got rotten indigestion.
What's up, Dawn? Oh, Davo's taken me to the hospital. She reckons they might be able to get a job for me working with the kids.
Oh, that's lovely, Dawn.
Fantastic. I'll keep my fingers crossed for you.
Oh, thanks, Jude. I reckon I'll need all the luck I can get.
Rubbish. They'll know a good thing when they see it. And tomorrow I'll get my sentence reduced, and before you know it, we'll be on the outside together.
Oh, Lizzie, do you really think so?
Of course. Good mates must always stick together.
Oh, you're my best mate, Lizzie.
Mrs. Davidson's waiting, Doreen. Make it quick.
Oh, yes, coming. Well, you lot, even if nothing happens, I'll get a few hours' holiday from this place.
Good luck, honey.
See you.
Oh, bye!
Face it, Jackson. You've been stood up.
Maybe we should go some other day, Mrs. Davidson. I don't feel so crash hot today.
You're not picking cold feet at this stage, are you, Doreen?
No, it's just that there's a lot of strangers in a hospital and I'm no good with people. They think I'm weird.
Oh, it's just your imagination.
No, it's not honest. I still get nightmares about the last time I was out. Those people in the factory, they thought I was a freak. I just couldn't stand it again. I'd rather be inside.
If you do get this job, Doreen, and it's still an if, you will be involved with children. Now, they don't think you're weird, do they?
No, I suppose not. Kids really like me.
Exactly, and that's all that counts. Now, come on, or we'll be late.
Mrs. Davidson, do you really think I've got a chance in a place like that?
If I didn't, we wouldn't be going. This could be the start of a whole new life for you, Doreen, and I really believe you can do it.
Thanks, Mrs. Davidson. I reckon if you can believe it, well, then I can too.
Do come in.
Thank you, Dr. Henderson.
Take a seat. So, this is Doreen.
Yes, sir.
Well, have you formed any opinion of my hospital so far?
Oh, it's real big, isn't it?
Yes, it is. And it needs a lot of staff to keep the wheels in motion. That's why our nurses' aid program is so important.
Important?
Well, of course. Especially in the children's wards. And you know how much attention they need.
Well, yeah, kids can keep you at it all day if you give them half a chance.
Right. That's why we need aides who can amuse them and at the same time keep an eye on their medical condition and summon a nurse when necessary. Kids need that attention and, well, there just aren't enough trained nurses to go round.
Oh, I'd never thought of it like that before.
Mrs. Davidson tells me you have a real gift.
Oh, no. I just reckon that kids can really tell whether you care about them or not. You can't con them.
My sentiments exactly. Tell me, why do you want to work with children?
Oh, gee, I don't know. I suppose I always took it for granted that I'd have babies of my own one day. I mean, most girls do, don't they? I had a baby once. She was real lovely. I only held her once before I gave her up for adoption. Oh, I loved her. But I just figured that her life would be better without me. And I thought I'd have other babies once I got married. But then I had the miscarriage and they told me that I couldn't have any more, ever. And I just felt, you know, sort of empty. Sounds a bit silly, doesn't it?
No, it doesn't sound the least bit silly. And you thought you'd fill that emptiness by caring for other people's children?
Well, yeah, sort of. I mean, it doesn't matter whose baby it is. They still all need love, and I've got plenty to spare.
Erica, you were right. This is quite a remarkable young woman.
I thought you'd be impressed.
Well, Doreen, perhaps we'd better find out what you think of us. What say we visit the children's ward?
Oh, that'd be real good, Doctor.
And then you can decide whether you'd really like to work here.
Hi. Oh, what's the matter with you? Come on, honey, what's wrong? Didn't your father explain things to you?
Judy, I just want to be by myself for a while.
Oh. Well, I can understand you wanting to be on your own, but you don't own this cell, you know that? Something we share, okay?
Oh, sure, why not? I seem to share everything. I've shared my father all his life. And now I have to share him with a bloody screw.
Your language is shocking, you know that?
Look, Judy, just don't make fun at me. I'm not in the mood.
Well, neither am I. Listen, if you're going to take all of this out on me, I think you owe it to me to tell me what's wrong. Now, what did he say?
He said he's taking her out to lunch. I mean, I'm stuck in here and he takes her screw out to lunch.
Oh, maybe he likes her.
Well, like her be damned, I'm his daughter.
You realize that he wouldn't have a daughter if it wasn't for Meg Jackson. You understand that, don't you? She saved your life. What do you expect him to do? Send her some sort of thank you note? Lately, Tracy, you've just become a bit of a spoiled brat.
It's just I don't want to share him anymore. I love him, Judy.
I know that, love. But...